much clear skies over us tonight. We do have some clouds that we see in the distance, and I'm going to take you out into the Atlantic, and we're going to get a good look. Hurricane Gabrielle right now, Category 4, second major hurricane of the season. Remember, Hurricane Aaron was a Category 5 as we went in the middle, early part of the season. So here's where we stand with the satellite picture, but going way out into the Atlantic, got some storms, Florida Peninsula here. But we can see that we get out a little farther here. We get a good look at Gabrielle. This is a well-defined hurricane, even from the infrared satellite imagery. Look at the eye spinning here. There's Bermuda, that little blip. So it's well east of there, already making some north and northeastward movement. We can also get another good look off of what's going on in our forecast here too for us as we get a look at what's there in the color and where we've got the stats for us at 140 mile per hour winds, gusts even higher, movement northeast at 13. There it went, underwent rapid intensification last night to a Cat 3, quickly Cat 4, and there it is. There's a look at the storms that are more on the northeast side of the storm at this point. So our forecast tracks have been consistent, maintaining Cat 4 status even through tomorrow, but we begin the weakening process, and I showed that that is going to be already entering the wind shear that's pushing that storm north and east. This could be heading all the way to Europe. We're talking Portugal and Spain and maybe even France if the storm holds. That brings some strong winds and even some very, very heavy rain those directions. Leading tropical wave next 3 to 7 days of 50-50 shot of development. Second tropical wave, low chance over the next couple of days, but the next 3 to 7 days, likely development. And that one looks to take the exact same track as Gabrielle. So we'll quickly run through this. Both of those tropical waves looking unimpressive right now. Leading tropical wave, let's talk about this. So I show you here as we go Puerto Rico. This is midweek. It just doesn't look much organization to it, not much strength. Turks and Caicos, Bahamas, then making its way maybe close to the Outer Banks and looks to be North Carolina, not seeing much. And if this would become a tropical depression, that's about as strong as it looks with this imagery. Gets taken up into an ordinary storm. That would be a tropical depression, tropical storm, or maybe even a hurricane. Our next named storm is likely to be that second tropical wave. That would be Humberto. And so we're only about into the list. We're way behind in schedule for the year, which I'm going to take every single time. So things are calm right now for us. The takeaway, no worries. Next week to 2 weeks. Real-time temperature 79, 81 at lakefront. Humidity's up just a little bit, but I'm tracking a front for you here. And it's been a long time since we've had our last front. We've been a little bit lucky in the late summer season getting in now fall. Began at 119 today, if you didn't know. The fall equinox, meteorologically, we did at the beginning of the month. But here's the front Wednesday night into Thursday. That's when it should come through and enhances our rain chance. It's been a long time since a 60% chance of rain. I would have the umbrella and the rain gear with you into Wednesday's forecast, maybe into Thursday too. Not much in the way of a rain chance tomorrow. I give it a 30% chance of an isolated storm. We're still running hot, or I'm going to call it warm for the time of the year, though. The typical high is 87. We're going 92, give or take a degree or two on either side. Wednesday's high-res forecast, this has been consistent with wanting to break out a lot more storm activity throughout a better part of the day. So I bumped up the rain chances to about a 60% chance, a little bit over 50-50. Still shows that the front could come through overnight Wednesday and then stall, and maybe even another wave of storms behind that on Thursday. So the Storm Prediction Center says a very low risk, some strong wind gust Wednesday night. Locally heavy rain Wednesday night into Thursday shows the timing of the actual front is still overnight. We go from 90s to Wednesday to Thursday, those temperatures down into the 80s, and we'll take the humidity down with it too. So the WDSU First Warning Weather 7-day, the front's going to bring in that much, much nicer air to finish the week, and that means this weekend could be spectacular.